know more such amazing stories from Indian history, click the bell icon and subscribe to Live History India.
A little after 5 p.m. on the 30th of January 1948, Mahatma Gandhi, supported by his grandnieces Abha and Manu, was walking down to the beautiful garden of Birla House in New Delhi for his daily prayer meeting, when a young man dressed in khaki stepped in front of him. He pulled out a pistol and fired 3 shots point blank into the 78-year-old Mahatma's abdomen. The crowd of about 500 who had gathered to see him was in shock, but they managed to seize the assassin, Nathuram Godse, a Brahmin from Pune and a member of the right-wing Hindu Mahasabha. The news spread quickly and disbelief, anger and grief took over. To calm the people, Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru addressed to the nation on All India Radio and said, "The light has gone out of our lives and there is darkness everywhere. I do not know what to tell you and how to say it. Our beloved leader, Bapu as we call him, is no more. A madman has put an end to his life. But that does not mean we should be weak. We must hold together and all our petty troubles and difficulties and conflicts must be ended in the face of this great disaster." The next day at around noon, the Mahatma's body was draped in the tricolour and over 2 million people arrived to pay respects to him. The 8-kilometer-long funeral procession took more than 5 hours to reach Rajghat from Birla House. On the banks of the Yamuna River, Mahatma Gandhi's eldest son, Devdas, lit his father's cremation pyre as the nation mourned. 20th century's greatest proponents of non-violence had become a victim of violence. A few months later, in May 1948, Gandhi's murder trial began in the historic Red Fort. It was conducted by a special court with Nathuram Godse as the main defendant and his collaborator Narayan Apte and 6 others as co-defendants. Godse claimed that his main provocation had been the Mahatma's constant appeasing of Muslims, especially his last pro-Muslim fast, which began on the 13th of January 1948. The government of India had withheld Pakistan's share of money, which the British owed jointly to the two dominions, a debt incurred on account of India's contribution to the Second World War. The amount was 550 million rupees. New Delhi had refused to release the money as it was angry with Pakistan for having recently attempted to seize Kashmir. Gandhi considered this spiteful and went on a fast unto death, which would end only if the money was transferred to Pakistan. For Godse, it was the trigger that led him to kill the Mahatma. Godse's justification for his actions did not stand up in the court of law, and he and Apte were sentenced to death and hanged in Haryana's Ambala jail in November 1949. Mahatma Gandhi's death marked the end of an era. He had left a legacy that was too powerful to describe and had touched minds and hearts way beyond India's borders. When he died, tributes flowed in from across the world. Physicist Albert Einstein said of the Mahatma, "A man who has confronted the brutality of Europe with the dignity of the simple human being, and thus at all times risen superior." When playwright George Bernard Shaw was asked for his impressions of the Mahatma, he replied, "You might well ask for someone's impression of the Himalayas." Well-known American journalist Louis Fisher said, "Just an old man in a loincloth in distant India. Yet, when he died, humanity wept